Tom Friedman, the book is That Used to Be Us. It talks about what's holding America back. It talks about fears of America's decline. With that backdrop, what is the major point and the framing of this book?
Well, David, what I and my co-author Michael Mandelbaum from Johns Hopkins are basically arguing is we've got good news and bad news. The bad news is this problem didn't start in 2008 with the subprime crisis. This problem, in our view, started at the end of the Cold War. The good news is there is a way out if we understand exactly where we are. I'd make four big points, basically. First of all, we made the worst mistake a country or species can make at the end of the Cold War. We misread our environment. We interpreted the victory in the Cold War, or the end of the Cold War, as a victory, and not understanding it was actually the onset of one of the biggest challenges we've ever faced as a country. We had just unleashed 2 billion people just like us. But the 90s turned out to be quite a party, thanks to the peace dividend, thanks to the massive productivity boost of the internet, and thanks, most importantly in many ways, to the collapse in oil prices, which was like a huge tax cut. Then that brings us into the 21st century. So really the 90s was like a 3,650-day victory parade for the United States. Start with the 2000s, 9/11, which we're going to talk to here. Tragically, 9/11 set us on a really bad course. We spent the last decade, in many ways necessarily, many ways excessively, chasing the losers from globalization rather than the winners. And we made up for a lot of the fall behind there by basically injecting ourselves with steroids. Just as baseball players did it to hit home runs, we injected ourselves with credit steroids to create a huge housing boom and construction boom to create jobs. The third, I think, big change is a big technological change. The world, the grid of the world, basically, the number of people who can compete, connect, and collaborate exploded in the last decade. You know, I wrote a book in 2004 called The World is Flat, which was about this connecting of the world. We've gone from connected to hyper-connected in terms of the people who are now competing with us and connecting with us. When we sat down to write this book, I actually went back to The World is Flat. I looked in the index, and I realized that Facebook wasn't in it. When I said The World is Flat, Facebook didn't exist, or for most people didn't exist. Twitter was a sound. The cloud was in the sky. 4G was a parking place. LinkedIn was a prison. Applications were what you sent to college. And for most people, Skype was a typo. Okay, that all happened in just the last 7 years. And what it's done is taken the world from connected to hyper-connected. And that's been a huge opportunity and a huge challenge. Lastly, I'd just say one thing. All of this is overlaid, and I'm interested in Doris's view on this in particular, with a generational shift. We went from the greatest generation, whose philosophy was basically save and invest, and we are still living off their saving and investing, to basically the baby boomer generation, whose philosophy turned out to be borrow and spend. And we've really shifted from a generation born in the Depression, World War II, and the Cold War. These were serious people. They wouldn't think of shutting down the government for a minute, okay, to a generation, basically, that is much less serious. We've gone from basically the values of the greatest generation, which were what my philosopher friend Dove Seidman calls sustainable values, values that sustain, to a baby boomer generation whose values are situational values. Do whatever the situation allows. You put them all together, and I think you really account for a lot of the hole we're in right now structurally.